Hello, world. It's my Darth Vader impression. Best one you'll see on the internet. The galaxy is full of computers, and seemingly any Tom, Jane, or Greedo can take a droid aside, pop open its head panel, and bleep, 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 bloop, program it up. But what is all this tech? How do Star Wars programming languages work? And why do I have almost conspiracy levels of suspicion that machines are the major players in this grand space epic? In honor of the new films coming out, I'm taking a step aside from showing you how code is part of our world and talking about programming in that galaxy long ago and far away. Welcome to CompChomp, the only show on the internets where we had to smush your favorite characters into tiny little boxes to avoid copyright infringement. Sorry about that. As a coder, one of the things I always notice on my trips to the galaxy is all of the technology that everyone seems to have access to, whether they're hotshot black-cloaked machine men or just some lowly farmers dozens of parsecs out in the boonies. We only get glimpses of pilots fiddling with knobs or astromech droids whipping out their hacking arms. But since we never get a thorough explanation about how these machines work, what could we possibly know about coding in the Star Wars universe? Well, fortunately for us nerds, George Lucas dropped hints all around the galaxy. Facts alert! My facts glasses. You know these facts are gonna be good, because I put on my facts glasses. You've got astromech droids that plug into ship sockets, machines that can hack other machines, well, slicing, they call hacking slicing, protocol droids that can translate between machines and humans, human-cyborg relations, and even humans getting in on the machine gig and cyborging up the place. These aren't even my glasses. You knew that though. When it comes to programming, we find out that R2-D2 speaks binary, and a little Jawa tells me that the moisture evaporator the film crew left in the Tunisian desert works like binary load lifters in most respects. Binary. Uncanny, they have binary. It's a way to count using only two values like we use in our technology for passing info and flipping switches. True, false, one, zero, on, off. And surely if they're using computers, they're using binary. False. What, you haven't heard of non-binary computers that use ternary and other multi-valued logic? But none of this is Star Wars binary anyway. Their capital B binary is what astromechs... I really love saying that word. Astromech. Astromech. It rolls off the tongue. Astromech. It's what astromech droids use to communicate when they're making all those bleeps and bloop sounds. It's not a counting system. It's a protocol. A language. Now, before you just shrug this off as a quirk or a teeny mistake, I felt your shoulders rising up. Maybe there are other uncanny twists in language use in the Star Wars universe that might justify this. Well, basically, yes. Get it? Basically? That English that you hear when you watch the movies, it isn't actually English. It's a totally different language known as Galactic Basic. I know this is a total tangent. Let's get back on track. Well, it's not even a total tangent. English doesn't work like English in Star Wars. So if English isn't English and binary doesn't mean binary in this galaxy, perhaps programming doesn't mean programming? The programming languages in Star Wars are actually a lot more like speaking and thinking. In a way, there's this whole unique communication pipeline going on here. A human talks to a protocol droid. A protocol droid gets things across to a binary speaking droid. And those guys, the ones that seem like the most robotic of all robots to us, they plug bloop, right into the machines and manipulate them. This more embodied view of programming as thinking and talking machines starts to make sense when you ask yourself what droids have that robots don't in our world. They're not just computers, are they? They're sentient. And if that's not clear enough from watching the movies, dig into the Star Wars lore for tons of robot consciousness love. From reference to sentience programming on the one hand, to C-3PO and R2-D2 straight up fearing for their lives and contemplating their own mortality. Reference. I said reference. And that's great for droids, but it kind of complicates our story. And it really complicates talking about programming languages in Star Wars. Because, like other intelligent critters, droids don't have to do what they're programmed to do. Just take our pal C-3PO. He tells us that it is against his programming to impersonate a deity. Meanwhile, he gives in and he impersonates a deity. Are you still skeptical? Well, take a look at this line that got cut from the script of Attack of the Clones. C-3PO reflects on human nature, and he says he's programmed, but at the same time, at a deeper level, his understanding goes against his programming. double frickin' whammy here. Not only does his programming not dictate his thinking, but his thinking gets deep. He is thinking about how he thinks about how humans think. That is crazy meta. All this thinking puts a dent in the simple programming pipeline that we figured out earlier. Speaking human to protocol droid to binary droid to machine terminal. This galaxy seems to be calling into question our very instinctual division between humans on the one side and machines on the other. It's not just humans and droids. C-3PO isn't human-droid relations, but human-cyborg relations. It's a man and machine continuum, and a continuum with thinking machines exercising their own judgment. Back here in the real world, we're already crawling towards judgmental robots. Friggin', just what I need, something else in my life judging me. Robots that are definitely programmable, but at the same time, they can say, nope, not gonna do it. And that robot judgment might actually be a good thing. There was this psychologist, Paul Meehl. He was one of the most influential names in his field, and he started analyzing the difference in outcomes between when machines made decisions and when people made decisions. And what he found is that even when you take experts in a field, and you compare their outcomes to decisions made by computers, the computers do better. And this isn't just in calculated things like mathematics and, say, investments, things with numbers. There was a meta-analysis that concluded that he was absolutely right when it comes to patient evaluations in clinical psychology. Computers are better at analyzing human psychology than humans are. Just imagine the kind of final calls that an AI would get in a galaxy that had discovered what I guess we'll go ahead and call Meehl's Law. You get to live your life and you get to speak your piece, but at the end of the day, the circuits are the ultimate judge. Now, if you follow that down the rabbit hole, the whole story starts to look a lot different. Then it's no surprise that from its core to its fringes, you've got ships and droids, blasters, mini computers, vaporators, everywhere tech. Tech that can ultimately override its own programming, think and communicate rather than just store data, take orders. It was all a hoax. The entire time, the humans, the organics, they were just pawns. Ah! Star Wars machines can think. They can make their own judgments and even override their own programming. But are they really as pivotal as I'm suggesting? Well, look no further than one of the very few characters who appears in every single movie. When asked who he'd missed the most, George Lucas gave a nod to the one he called the hero of the whole thing, this little guy. So, programmable machines, they make the decisions. They have the power, and even if you're not interested in the background trivia like we are, and you just care about the main story, I know your type, even then, they are still flat out admitted to be the major players in the film. But maybe this programmer's analysis of Star Wars is starting to sound a bit twisted. Twisted and evil? Being more machine now than man definitely comes with loads of power, but it also brings up the darker side of the code-gone sentient nature of Star Wars programming languages. With Meehl levels of machine judgment being handed out, the relationship between man and machine had a darker flip side, vilification and subjugation.
Vilification and subjugation.
With AI getting so advanced, organics needed to maintain control. Organics. I love Star Wars terminology. So machines are portrayed as cold and evil. They're enslaved to work for the organics, and they're programmed. Their memories get wiped, and all the while, these are thinking, feeling decision makers. Yeah, guess what? In this part of space-time, not only did programming mean communicating with advanced machines that can make their own decision, it was also the need to control these machines, to enslave fellow sentient beings just to keep their power in check. Does this brighten up where it's like... So, while I can't personally open up a droid head myself and punch in the right codes, you can definitely see how the programming languages of Star Wars open up a whole can of hyperspace wormholes about sentience and intelligence, the man-machine relationship in their galaxy and ours. Come back next time to talk about how programming works in our galaxy, and may the code be with you.